Most of the events in the Bible that ufologists ascribe to extraterrestrial intelligence have effects that run from the benign to the beneficial. But that is not always the case. As in the story of the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah. As told in the Bible, the inhabitants of these two sister cities were so debauched and sinful that there was no hope of turning back their evil ways. The only solution, total extermination. Then the Lord rained on Sodom and Gomorrah brimstone and fire from the Lord out of heaven. And he overthrew those cities. In his 1968 book, The Chariots of the Gods, Eric von Däniken presented a different theory about the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah.
Eric von Däniken had speculated that Sodom and Gomorrah might have been destroyed by extraterrestrials using nuclear weapons. The reason he came to this conclusion is the description that fire and brimstone came down from the sky. It certainly would get the attention of planet Earth pretty fast if we really concluded that extraterrestrials had destroyed whole cities because they didn't like them.
However, there are other theories about the destruction of these cities. Some believe the story may have been used as a mythological warning. A lesson passed down through the millennia to reinforce the importance of piety.
God removed the Sodomites and the citizens of Gomorrah from existence, and that's what the text talks about. Fire rained down from heavens and wiped them all out. The text tells us that when a human civilization becomes reprobate, they can't be saved.
The other way to look at Sodom and Gomorrah is that if the towns ever actually existed, and if those towns were destroyed, were almost certainly destroyed by some natural means. It's such a metaphor for a religious idea, that is, man was evil and deserved to be punished for his iniquity.
Archaeological evidence has emerged that shed some scientific light upon this ancient story.
Archaeologists, in looking at the southeastern plain of the Dead Sea, have located approximately the right place where we would expect to see cities of Sodom and Gomorrah.
The remains of these cities, called Babadra and Numeria, offer tantalizing clues that may prove part of the story of Sodom and Gomorrah.
In Babadra, we see that there was broad destruction across the mound. Next, we find at Numera that there is a layer of ash which can suggest that the city was burnt.
But the cause of their destruction still cannot be scientifically proven. And therefore, what or who caused it remains open to speculation.
The bigger issue is whether or not extraterrestrials are so much involved in the development of life on Earth that they in fact would destroy a whole city or perhaps a whole group of people.
That the biblical God or angels were really UFOs from another planet may be a radical idea. But it's possible that modern-day theorists aren't the first ones to suppose this extraterrestrial angle. In the 15th century, artwork portraying biblical scenes began to emerge, with mysterious saucer-shaped objects seeming to hover in the sky.
I find that the Renaissance artwork itself is very intriguing, just all by itself. You've got these images of UFOs with the Madonna image and scenes of Jesus on the cross. And in the background, you've got a little black dot or a saucer-shaped UFO with a dome on it. And what these were done 1,500 years after the fact.
It's a matter of a Rorschach test for the observer. You place attributes onto those paintings and drawings and artwork. They may be hats, they may be crockery or saucers or other things of that shape, but not necessarily flying saucers.
But more and more, people seem to believe that UFOs are real and are alien. Even organized religion hasn't completely closed the book on the extraterrestrial possibility.
The Vatican has made a statement that said that they are not to be feared and not to be demonized.
Monsignor Corrado Balducci, who is a consultant to the Vatican, has been on Italian television several times saying that he believes UFOs are real and that they are extraterrestrial.
If these theories are proven true, what might the future hold for Western religion?
Western religion would change completely if extraterrestrials were proved to be real. It would change all the stories in the Bible, and it would change how we thought about the Bible, because a highly technological extraterrestrial may provide some explanations for some of the miracles that happen in the Bible.
But in the absence of hard evidence that either proves or disproves the existence of UFOs, belief in the UFO phenomenon is based mostly on faith, much the same basis as a belief in God.